the writing process for this record took a long time. We wrote and recorded Feel Something and probably didn't write anything for like over a year. We were all just kind of burnt out.
It was just a tough record to write, so it just put us off from writing at all.
With Feel Something, I feel like I was nervous about writing music that I felt was good enough. Obviously, like I dug really, really deep into my emotions and my mental illnesses and all the things that kind of make up who I am as a person, and I poured everything into Feel Something. And because of that, it sort of sent me into this weird place afterwards where I kind of felt as though like I didn't have anything left to offer. And because of that, like I feel like after Feel Something, I sort of had this mental break a little bit. I've dealt with anxiety and I've dealt with depression my whole life, but this was like a new kind of level. And when we went into Feel Something, with it being like our first full-length album, there was like, I think, a lot of pressure on us to, you know, just write that much music. That was more music than we'd ever written as a band before. So when we were doing this album, the writing process was so much more streamlined. We went from, you know, going into Feel Something with 9 songs to going into this album cycle with 17 songs completely written. Just the sheer amount of things that we could choose from to pick what songs were going to be the absolute best for this record and which songs we felt were going to be the strongest, it ended up making for, I think, much better songs and better songwriting altogether, because we're less worried about, okay, we need to finish all these songs, and more worried about what can we do to make these songs perfect.
On Feel Something, we would all get together in a room, like a practice space or one of our houses, and we would jam. And I think that's kind of how Feel Something sounds like more of a garage band kind of record, which I think was very important for us to find our sound as a group. But then when this record came along, it's like, let's figure out a way to just sound bigger and more dynamic. And so this one, we didn't get together and jam in the same room at all. A lot of it was just kind of done on the computer.
Probably 90% of these drums were written on a computer before they were ever played. But the reason why I like doing that is because it kind of gets me out of my comfort zone. I'm able to take a step back and sort of look at each song from another perspective without having to jam it and think about playing it, and then also listen and, is this cool? Should I change this or that? And also to have more time with these parts just on my own to kind of think about it and sort of let that marinate, versus with a group of guys when you have a bunch of eyes and ears on you waiting to see what you come up with on the spot.
Didn't really matter whose instrument it was, if it was drums or guitar or bass, you know, like we all had some input on it. Like there's some bass parts I didn't write that Ira wrote. There's some guitar parts that I wrote and that he didn't. We just figured out how to really work creatively together as a band.
And I think that just gives this record that much more of a, like, a diverse sound, you know, rather than just being one instrument, one person. I really wanted us to make a record that when you listen to it, all they hear in it is us. At least for me, like, the difference between writing the two, I came into Movements not having, like, recorded anything with them and, like, being under the impression, like, I needed to write stuff to sound like Movements. And that's how I kind of approached Feel Something. I mean, I still wrote what I wanted to write, but I still had that like in the back of my mind. We were all Feel Something in like drop D, and I've written in like drop D my entire life. This record, LP2, is entirely in standard, and that's something that we did consciously. It was basically like relearning how to write songs, because I was so used to playing in a different tuning, and it was honestly a blessing in disguise, because I grew so much from it. Always a little bit scared to have two dominant guitars going at the same time, because I'm the only guitar player, but for this record I just kind of said fuck it.
We just have so many different tones, where I feel like in previous records we've done, we kind of just kept it to like this basic tone that would be throughout the whole record. This time around, like, we're just listening to the song, we're like, okay, what is gonna mesh the best here? We're not just sticking to one thing, we're just doing what's best for every song. Same goes for all the other instruments. I think the only thing that is consistent across the board is vocals. I think those are the one thing that's going to carry a consistent feel, but all the guitars, the bass, even like the, what drums we're using, what cymbals we're using, just change by song. So it's going to make this album sound very diverse.
There's a lot of the original sort of ideas that make movement songs. I talk about my mental illness a lot. I talk about other people's mental illnesses in this album. I talk about loss and sort of emptiness and loneliness because of loss. But at the same time, there's like a handful of wild cards. There are themes and topics in this album that we've never touched on before, and a lot of topics that are more mature and a lot more adult than what we might have done in the past. I think a lot of the stuff that we write about just has to do with kind of everyday life. On this record in particular, like, Will has really shown us how much he cares about our band and how much he believes in what we can do and the potential that we show. And he's really sort of earned his place as what we would say is like a fifth member of our band, you know, more so than just being a member who stands on stage and plays the music, but really at the core of this band. Movements wouldn't be Movements if it weren't for Will and if it weren't for all of the ideas that he's contributed and that he constantly brings to the table.
I feel like we really, all five of us, wrote this record together. This is such an open and creative process.
I think Will and I have such a great synergy when it comes to writing and tracking drums, and he's always pulling the absolute best takes that he can get from you. Every time we go into the studio with him, I come out a better musician because of it.
Working with Movements is straight up one of my favorite things to do. For one, they're so talented. They're very inspired people, so they want to push themselves. They just want to do what feels right to them. They're just so open. They're so open to do things, and we just try to create the best song we can possibly create at that time. From the core writing to the very last take of the production, of the mix, of the whatever. So it's fun, man. It's kind of a perfect storm, I think, putting us five in a room together.
There were a lot of stressful moments for sure over the last like year and a half or 2 years, just the daunting task of writing another record. But I think in the end, it turned out better than what I wanted it to turn out to be. We still stuck with a lot of things that people will be like familiar with. I think it's just really important to always do your own thing. And, you know, I feel like we accomplished so much with this record by being open-minded and wanting to push to the furthest extent we could. I just want people to see that and be able to get inspired.
And I feel like this record, I want people to see and appreciate all the other stuff we added. There's just a lot of melody, a lot more notes. Like, there's big feeling songs, and I think we really push the envelope of what Movements is.
I think it comes across really clearly that our sound is maturing and that we have a clearer direction of where we want to take things. I think that we made something that we're even more proud of than Feel Something.
I'm just happy that these songs are something that I am proud of, you know, and that it's something that I feel like I can keep doing. Whereas at the end of Feel Something, I felt like I didn't even want to touch music for 2 years. We have all grown so much as musicians and as writers and as artists. To get to the point that we're at now, our music is showing that progression.
They just know they want to be an expressive band and they want to grow. The confidence in that is stronger than ever since Feel Something. And that's gonna make them a fucking unstoppable force, you know, because when you have that, when you have the talent, when you have that ability to recognize your strong points and to know what you want to do and to know that there are no limits for you, you know, that's just a recipe for a crazy, inspiring career.